Welcome to your state capitol. I'm Gina Walsh, president of the Missouri State Building and Construction Trades. Today we stand as one. We are here to make our voices heard. One simple message. No more. No more legislation aimed at eliminating our ability to organize. No more legislation aimed at restricting our right to elect our representation. No more legislation aimed at reducing job place safety. And no more legislation aimed at reducing our wages. We shall not let them silence the working men and women of this state with their anti-worker, pro-big business agenda. We must protect the hard-working, fought gains that our predecessors secured. If we lose, the entire middle class loses. Everyone who works for a living will pay the price. As hard-working Missourians, it is our job to be engaged, to stay informed on the issues that affect us and our families, and make sure our elected officials know what it is. Together, we can make Missouri a better future place to live. At this time, I would like to introduce to you State Representative Jake Hummel. He is the minority leader in the House and a proud member of IBEW Local 1. Jake is here to introduce his colleagues in the General Assembly.
Thank you, Senator Walsh. I want to thank everybody for being here today, and it's been my honor to introduce some of the members of the General Assembly that on day in and day out have my back and have your back every day in this state capitol. To my left, I want to introduce Representative Bill Otto, who is also the Labor Caucus Chair. Bill represents Maryland Heights and St. Charles. And also is a member of the Air Traffic Controllers Union. State Representative John Rizzo, who is a member of the CWA out of Kansas City. Representative Joe Runyons, who is an IBEW member out of Kansas City. State Representative Keith English, who is an IBEW member out of St. Louis. State Representative Bob Burns, who is a Teamster out of St. Louis County. State Representative Carla May, member of CWA out of St. Louis City. There's some other members behind me, but they will be introduced later on. It is now my pleasure to introduce... Oh, never mind, they're late to the party. It's all right, we're legislators, that's what we do. State Representative Michael Butler from St. Louis City. State Representative Stacy Newman from St. Louis County. State Representative Michelle Cracky from St. Louis City. State Representative Tom McDonald from Kansas City. State Senator Scott Sifton from St. Louis County. These people work here every day and look out for your interests, and we owe them a round of thanks. They truly work every day for us. It's now my honor to introduce my counterpart in the Senate as the minority leader in the state Senate, also my senator, Senator Joe Keavney.
Thank you, Jake, and thank you everybody for being here. I'm Senator Joe Keavney of St. Louis. I'm the Senate Minority Floor Leader, and I'm here to introduce the governor. As a state senator, Jay Nixon supported the laws which protected the workers. As attorney general, he enforced those laws. And as governor, he has continued to stop all the attempts to repeal those laws. Let's show our appreciation for our governor, Jay Nixon.
Thank you. We are down here on the grass for a very good reason. We're doing construction over here.
Yeah!
It is always nice to come to work in the morning and see the folks in the colored shirts that shake our hands when we walk in, and then they head right into a lot tougher job than what we got, which is working on this old building to make sure it shines the way we want it to. And we're going to do just that. And we appreciate those hard workers that come here and help us make this Capitol shine even better. Thank you. I want to thank Senator Keavney for his leadership each and every day, and quite frankly, sometimes at night, in the Missouri Senate to protect workers, their families, and to protect everybody's rights, civil rights, human rights, and the great freedom that we all have. I also want to thank House Minority Leader Jake Hummel for his dedicated and unwavering support of working families in the Show-Me State. Leaders Keavney and Hummel are working hard to balance budgets, maintain fiscal discipline, grow our economy, and fight for working families in our state. And you know, that's what you want them spending their time on. That's on right. Offense for the state of Missouri, not on defense for people taking away things you already earned. I also want to recognize our Department of Labor. Since I took office, our Missouri Department of Labor has been vigilant and aggressive on behalf of Missouri workers, and the numbers back that up. Just real quick numbers. We've identified more than 47,000 misclassified workers, 47,000. Uncovered more than $9.7 million in unpaid unemployment insurance taxes. And we stood up for working Missourians by enforcing the prevailing wage laws, recovering more than $7.5 million back in the pockets of workers in Missouri. You know the Director of Labor, member of my cabinet, a great leader in his own regard, former Senator, now Labor Director Ryan McKenna. Thank you for your leadership, Ryan. You know, right now we're in the middle of the 2016 legislative session, and unlike some other states, our budget is in balance, revenues are up, our AAA credit rating is intact, and Missouri's unemployment rate just dropped to 4.2%. Folks, that is lower than the national average and the lowest it's been since 2000. Okay? Yeah. Not done yet. You saw a company doubling down on Bridgeton yesterday. If you read the paper today, a biotech company that is going to add 144 jobs there. At the same time, over in Kansas City side, adding to our auto sector strength over there. Grupo Angela, a company I met with in Spain, expanding their operations here. The bottom line is our economy is growing. As long as we keep our focus on what's right, we're going to continue to get people back to work and expand opportunities for everybody. I know our secret why this economy is getting better. Really, the secret to our success is pretty simple. We have the hardest working, most highly skilled, and safest workforce in the world. Folks, I sit across the table from a lot of people doing a lot of deals, and there hasn't been a single time in which I've pledged that we could get something done on time, on budget, professionally done, that we didn't meet that goal. And I thank you as governor of the state for backing me up when I do that. I remember like yesterday when we were finishing that Stan Musial span in St. Louis, I came to the last, when they were finishing right in that middle, so I walked out there and, oh my God, it's like 200 feet down to the water and these iron workers are hanging out there and they want me to walk out there, which I did not do. It's important I finish my term. Yeah. But the bottom line, seeing those workers there and workers all across our state. Many of you know that I carried a union card for 7 years. When I left that job my last year, it was the summer in which I'd gone to law school, and half the summer I worked construction and the other half I was a law clerk. So I moved jobs in the middle of that summer. When I was leaving, my crew that I was working with had a little ceremony and gave me my shovel that I used for those years of work in construction, 7 years. It was pretty beat up, but they told me to take it with me, and I did. When I got back to college, I defrosted my freezer with it, the first thing. But it has been in every office I've ever had when I've stood for election, and it's in the governor's office here. because I want to remember why I'm doing what I'm doing. So that hardworking people who get up every day and compete on the job site know that they got somebody in the executive position leading our state that respects work, supports their excellence, and will always be unwavering in providing opportunities for you to get to work. This morning I spoke at a thing in Columbia, and I've got to leave here in a few minutes. I've got to be down at the lake speaking something else. But the thing I was speaking at up there was a disaster management training we're doing with the Red Cross to set up these MARCs, these multi-agency resource centers. And I just want to say thanks to the folks that helped us after Joplin. You know, there was a move afoot in this building right here to say, let's not build it back the same way. Let's lower wages. Let's get the lowest bid we possibly can. Let's get rid of the prevailing wage because we're in a hurry. And that didn't happen. It didn't happen because of people like Joe Keavney and Jay Hummel and all of us here. But that didn't happen. And when Joplin was rebuilt with prevailing wage, okay? We're coming up on 5 years from that tornado. We've rebuilt the schools, the houses, the hospitals, opened a new med school down there. Unemployment rate in Joplin is now 3.9% below the state average, and that community is stronger and better. The work that was done there by hardworking Missourians to make sure it was going to be built to last is making a difference now and will for generations to come. Now, thanks is something that the working men and women don't hear enough of, especially from folks over here. Some lawmakers and special interests who back them still seem to think that the way to lift up our economy is to tear down working families. Now, never in my 30 years of public service have I seen this much anti-labor activity in the legislature, never. Instead of putting forward policies that would strengthen the middle class, they've launched an all-out attack on the folks who created it. Now, we've beaten back these attacks before. When they passed paycheck deception, I vetoed it. We held that veto. When they said, let's get rid of the prevailing wage, I said, not on my watch. And we still got the prevailing wage in the show me state. And when last year, for the first time in Missouri history, the General Assembly passed a so-called right to work, I wasted no time in vetoing that bill because right to work is wrong and will not work in Missouri. Now, these special interests have supported that law through everything they had at us. They aired misleading radio and television ads. They sent lobbyists here to persuade, and they even threatened lawmakers, tried to get them to switch their votes. And you know what? In some other state, that might have worked. But in the show-me state, when you look into your elected leader's eyes, and you see them back in your home district, and you ask for their commitment, and you shake their hand the same way you make your commitment to work hard every day and provide value on the job site, guess what? They stick. I want to thank Jake and Joe and everybody else that worked to make sure that veto was upheld. Very important, okay? I went up to D.C. and spoke to the National Building Trades Meeting in Washington. And I told your brothers and sisters across the nation that Missouri is strong because we're union. And we're going to stay that way. Yeah. But I will tell you, these special interests pushing this anti-worker agenda are back again this year. Earlier this month, they passed paycheck deception again. And this time, they went even further by opening up new avenues for lawsuits against employee associations, including those representing teachers and first responders. So not only are they coming after unions, they're giving my union, the lawyers, more business. I don't think that's really good for our state. But I don't think saying you're supporting workers by having extra loss, take away their rights, and then put lawsuits in there is a way to deal with this stuff, guys. It's wrong concept, executed wrong. It's double wrong. Suing cops and teachers is not the way to move our state forward. It's just not. And that's why I dusted off that veto pen and vetoed that misguided bill, and we need to hold that veto. Yeah! You know, this is not about public employees and paperwork. This is just another attempt to erode the hard-fought rights that form the foundation of the American middle class. The right to a decent wage, the right to health care and compensation if you get hurt, the 40-hour work week, and the right to be able to retire with dignity after a lifetime of toil. That's what this fight is about. And that's why we must stand again together and win it. The special interests who don't share our values will try to divide us. They'll say to some of you, I'll just sit this one out. Maybe it doesn't touch your craft. Well, I'm here to say that when they attack one hardworking Missouri family, they attack all hardworking Missouri families. Today, their target might be teachers and caregivers, but tomorrow, make no mistake, it'll be sheet metal workers, electricians, and a prevailing wage, okay?
That's right.
That's why we need to send a clear, unambiguous message that working people built this country. They built the middle class, and they will stand united to defend the values we all share anytime and anywhere they're threatened. Now, I only got 285 days left as governor. Yeah, well, I just want to tell everybody here that when I signed up for this duty, I said I'd finish. I said that I would complete the task. And you can rest well assured that when it comes to the last 100 days of Nixon administration, I will work just as hard in the last 100 days, just as focused as I did the first 100 days. Okay. As it says in the Art of War, when you have completed 90% of the distance of a journey, 90% of the effort remains to finish it.
Right.
So you can rest well assured that we will all work extremely hard to finish it.
Thank you.
Last thing, and I'm sorry to go long here, but I lost my father about 6 weeks ago. We all had losses in our families. But he was part of that generation in this country that was in World War II, was in Korea, wore the uniform of our country, never asked for anything back. He was a young guy in DeSoto, Missouri when Pearl Harbor happened. He was only 16 years old. Couldn't join the Navy till he was 17. So he went up to St. Louis and worked in a steel factory for 4 months until on his birthday, he could stand up and go fight for America. And when the Korean War was there, he stood up again. Like all those members of this greatest generation, we stand on their shoulders. It was those same folks that passed the laws they're trying to get rid of, okay? It was the same folks that fought in this country through the 20s, the 30s, and the 40s, and the 50s to make sure that if you worked hard, that you could live an independent life, that you could make a living wage, that you wouldn't have to come to your Capitol and play defense. You could come up here and say, how do we build more things? How do we build more roads, more bridges, more things where we can work? So we stand at a moment right now. When we beat this down and shift and move forward on offense, a lot more people will be working. A lot more people will be working. The other thing, there's a whole lot of people in this state that are working that aren't as organized as you are. And if the top of the rope and the top of the wages moves down, everybody below you moves down.
That's right. Yep.
You stand for all the working people in the state. I just ask you over this next 7 weeks, please work as hard as you can to make sure these vetoes are supported and that these members know how important it is that we support you, not attack you, that we respect you, not disrespect you, and that we work together on the priorities to move this great state forward. Thank you, and God bless.
Thank you, Governor Nixon. Good afternoon. I'm Senator Kiki Curls of Kansas City. It's my honor to introduce our Secretary of State, Jason Kander. As a state representative and now as Secretary of State, Secretary Kander has pushed for ethics in government and early voting while protecting all citizens' right to vote. At this time, without further ado, I would like to introduce to you Secretary of State Jason Kander.
Thank you. My friend Senator Curls is a fierce advocate for labor and for all Missourians. Let's give her a round of applause. Thank her for everything she does. Thank you all for being here and fighting for the rights of working Missourians. I know sometimes it probably seems daunting, seems like we're outnumbered here, but I am confident that we can win when I look at this group of people working together, because Missourians are on our side. Just look at the group of folks we have out here to stand with you today. 6 out of 8 statewide elected officials in Missouri are against paycheck deception and right to work. Lieutenant Governor Kinder and Senator Blunt are the only holdouts, and that is quite a coalition. I'm going to do a little math for you real quick. If you add up the votes for the statewide elected officials, state representatives, and state senators who are against paycheck deception, you get 7.8 million votes. That's a lot of votes. In fact, it's nearly 4 million more votes than all the folks who support paycheck deception got. So when the majority party in the Capitol tells you that they can do what they want because it's the will of the majority, tell them to count the votes. They are wrong. Only in the gerrymandered fantasy land that is the Missouri State Capitol is passing paycheck deception a priority. I've traveled to every county in this state over the past 6 months, and literally no one has brought it up. Missourians don't want paycheck deception. Yeah. You know what? I'd also like to point out that Missourians don't want to legalize discrimination against their LGBT friends and neighbors either. SJR 39 is another terrible bill being considered here that we all need to defeat. Yeah! Yeah! You know what Missourians do want? A level playing field. They want the minimum wage to be a livable wage. They want women to be paid the same amount as men for doing the same job, and they certainly don't want any part of this war on working Missourians taking place in the Capitol. So I hope that the legislature moves on and doesn't try to override the governor on paycheck deception. But if they do, let's beat it. And then let's beat the folks who support it in November. Thank you all. Thank you all very much for being here and for all the hard work you do. Now, let's do what we do best. Let's get to work. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Senator.
Working people of this state have an absolute champion in Jason Kander.
Yeah!
My name is Steven Weber. I'm a state representative from Boone County. We got some Central Missouri labor folks here today. A few of us. We're gathered from different trades, from different unions, from different locals to ask for one thing, and that's a level playing field. What we want is an opportunity to earn a fair day's wage for a fair day's work. This idea of a level playing field and equal opportunity and responsibility is central to the labor movement. It should also be central to state government. Here in Jefferson City, the elected official that's charged with ensuring accountability and a level playing field is our state auditor, Nicole Galloway. Auditor, let me say a nice thing about you. Auditor Galloway started out as a fraud investigator in the private sector, and now she makes sure that taxpayer dollars are responsibly spent here in Jefferson City. She's proven to be tough, to be independent, and to be an absolute friend of working people across the state, our auditor, Nicole Galloway.
Thank you, Representative Weber. I've known Stephen for a long time. Stephen fought for his country as a United States Marine. Stephen. Stephen has fought for you in the Missouri House, and I know he will continue that fight in the Missouri Senate when he wins in November. Thank you all for being here today. Thank you for being here to tell your story to the elected officials in that building that are supposed to be representing you. Your story is the difference between a growing middle class for future generations and gutting Missouri families, setting us all back. That story is personal to me, and I know it is personal to you, because the fights in this building, fights over your right to earn a good income and raise a family with pride, can be described as nothing but personal. And I want to share my story with you. It starts in 1963 with my great-grandfather, Ollie Truman, building the arch as a member of Operating Engineers Local 513. It continues today with my uncle working a crane as a member of that very same local. Just as my family has, you have worked to build this state, from our landmarks, to our homes, to our workplaces, to the very roads we travel. I'm proud of my family's story, where we've come from, and where we're going. My children and your children deserve that same level of pride. I want them to have an equal playing field when it comes to work and education and opportunities to succeed in Missouri. But you may have noticed too many folks in this building don't care about you. They're focused on new ways to discriminate, new ways to cut salaries, new ways to divide us. Really, none of this is new. It's all the same tired story. Economic prosperity will come if we can only pay employees less. That's false. Yeah! Because we shouldn't be taking away workers' rights. We should be making real change designed to actually help working families, making sure employment benefits serve their purpose and are there when folks need that support. Ensuring an equal playing field for women and men who do the same job and should receive the same wages. And never, never allowing so-called right to work in Missouri. Now, I just don't point the finger. I know I'm one of the officials in this building that represents you. And now I know I can do something that matters to you. Making sure prevailing wage is being followed in this state. Before I was state auditor, I was treasurer of Boone County, just north of here. My job was to make sure prevailing wage was followed. I figured out how to make sure workers got paid prevailing wage. It was pretty simple. Pay the contractors after you were paid the wage you earned. I'm going to continue my commitment to you and the commitment I started years ago. I will audit compliance of prevailing wage in this state because you and your family deserve it. Yeah! The dream of hard work improving life for Missouri families is real today, but I know we have to fight for it. And that means working together and standing together. I will stand with you. The officials on this stage will stand with you. Thank you for what you're doing on behalf of Missouri families, on behalf of my family, and behalf of your own. Thank you for being here.
Thank you, Nicole. My name is Tommy Pearson. I represent District 66. It is my distinct honor and privilege to present to you our next speaker. He is the treasurer for our state, elected in 2008, and is now serving in his second and final term as state treasurer. As the son and grandson of a union carpenter, the labor movement has always been part of his life. He himself worked as a teamster and has carried those lessons throughout his time in office. A state treasurer, he is unique position to see how the budget and the economy can lift up the middle class and continue to find ways to support labor and the individuals who keep our communities, state, and country moving in any way that he can. Won't you join me as I present to you our state treasurer, none other than Clint Zweifel. Yeah! Give it up for him.
Thank you, Representative Pearson. Representative Pearson has been standing up strong for working families ever since he took this responsibility. Woo! Thank you. Yeah! And you know, I also wanted to recognize our state auditor, Nicole Galloway, who is a bright light for working families for years to come. Let's give her a round of applause. Yeah! You know, as I conclude my second term in office, I get a chance to be able to do many things for what maybe feels like the final time. And I can tell you that there is nothing that makes me more proud than being part and being standing with here in solidarity today. For the last 15 years, I've walked into this building and have brought a part of you and a part of the labor movement to work with me every single day. When I led a commission to build housing here in Missouri for our vulnerable Missourians, I made sure that the wages that we paid reflected the true value of workers and understood that a race to the bottom in wages and benefits is bad for our economy and it's bad for workers. And when I oversee our college savings program, I do so knowing that the savings in those accounts come from the sweat of working families. And when I invest your tax dollars, I do it in a way that honors the middle class, workers' rights, their health, their safety, their future, and their dignity and that of their children every single day. And I tried my best to be a voice in Jefferson City and around Missouri to lift up men and women who build our state from the ground up, rightfully valuing them for their contributions to our institutions, to our families, and to our communities. And I've seen those contributions firsthand in my entire career, both in public service and in the labor movement. Because the fact is, labor touches all of us every day. I've seen the men who have spent 8, 10, or 12 hours a day melting cast iron in an underground furnace so that we have brakes and rotors for our cars that are safe and sound. And I've seen my dad on job sites at 15 degrees and at 100 degrees and everything in between, playing a role in building buildings that we hold dear. And I've seen grocery workers working long shifts, picking orders at 5 degrees to ensure that we have food on our tables. And I've seen auto factories in Missouri and Detroit that build the best products in the world. Now, we've dealt with some difficult changes over the last 15 years. A conversation that once revolved around fair wages and job security has devolved into this blind, empty partisanship and extremism. We have a generation of politicians, some of them in that building, who think that hating unions, attacking working people, is some sort of a box to check for party admission, another notch on their belt.
Many of them know little about unions other than what they've been told about those who fund them.
Kick out the trash.
But what they forget, that unions represent the history of our country, that of shared sacrifice, shared responsibility, and the shared benefits that come from that. That the best economies reward productivity, reward training, excellence, not just for the top few, but share those benefits with it all. And that the best, strongest economies, they understand a very, very important lesson. That the simple idea of a fair day's work for a fair day's pay has profound consequences for our families and for our economy, lifting up everyone. A good job can mean everything for a family.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Now, I'm confident that your voice has been key, and that as we look to the arc of history, those on both sides of the aisle are going to judge these attacks on unions and workers as wrong and an utter misunderstanding of what organized labor really represents: unity, fairness, and strength. And the good news, you're still standing.
Amen.
The biggest, most important honor that I've had in public service for the last 15 years is representing you. Thank you for giving me that opportunity.
Thank you, Treasurer Zweifel. I want to real quickly introduce a few more members that have come out in the meantime. To my right, State Representative Jeannie Kirkton from St. Louis County. State Representative Gail McCann Beatty from Kansas City. State Representative Judy Morgan from Kansas City. State Representative Ira Anders from Kansas City. State Representative Kip Kendrick from Columbia. State Representative Deron McGee from Kansas City. State Representative Kevin Englund from St. Francis. State Representative Charlie Knorr from Springfield. State Representative Margo McNeil from St. Louis County. State Senator Jason Holzman from Kansas City. State Representative Deb Lavender from St. Louis County. State Representative Sue Meredith from St. Louis County. State Representative Rochelle Walton Gray from St. Louis County. And State Senator Jill Shoup from St. Louis County. I just want one real quick announcement. If at 2 o'clock on the side gallery of the House, we're going to honor our Vietnam veterans. If there's any union members that are Vietnam veterans and you're still here at 2 o'clock, we'd love to honor you on the side of the House if you come up to the third floor. Thank you.
Thank you, Representative Hummel. For our last speaker, it's my privilege to introduce to you. He's a Cass County prosecutor. He prosecuted more contractors for violating prevailing wage in Missouri history. As a state senator, he defended project labor agreements and prevailing wage in the legislature. And as attorney general, he continues to enforce prevailing wage and workers' compensation laws to protect and promote Missouri workers. As a woman in the trades, it gives me great pleasure to introduce our next governor, a man so dedicated to the men and women of our labor movement, who leads, I got great things to say, General, who leads by unwavering example, unafraid to share his convictions, his commitment to organized labor, fair wages, good benefits, one of our strongest allies, Attorney General and my friend, Chris Koster.
I want to start by saying something that all of us feel in our heart. The fact that we have to come to Jefferson City and rally here on this lawn year after year for good wages for 6 million Missourians is proof that there is something terribly broken inside that state capitol. In too many ways, this feels like Groundhog Day. We are here again, outside the Missouri Capitol, fighting off attempts by out-of-state interests to divide us, the working people of this state. Under their guise of economic freedom, special interest groups are lobbying this building to pit working men and women against one another in an effort to drive down wages in our state. They believe that the bonds that tie Missouri workers together are weak. They believe that they can break you, but they are dead wrong. What they don't understand is that your bond is not just about a job. It's about how our state has built a middle class over the past 90 years. And these bonds forged between you over time are not easily broken. When I was still a Cass County prosecutor and a member of the other party, you all never shrunk from embracing me. And forever I thank you for that loyalty. Together, we understood that working to boost wages in Missouri and to protect workers' benefits was in the best interest of all Missourians. That is why I'm proud to have prosecuted more than one-third of the prevailing wage violations in this state over the last 20 years. Yay! It's why I'm proud, along with my co-workers over at that Attorney General's office, to have taken on companies who knowingly misclassify workers to avoid paying payroll taxes in this state, and why I will always stand with you to protect good wages through collective bargaining and to fight against right to work. Yeah. Yeah. 8 years ago, when I faced a choice in my own life, a choice of remaining with my former party or effectively representing the working men and women of this state, the decision was never hard for me. You cannot break your word to your friends, and you cannot break your word to the people of Missouri, and that is why I joined with you. Yay! That sign up there, in Latin, it says, "Let the welfare of the people be the supreme law." It's not just our state's motto. It's a basic bargain that has been promised to you from Missouri's founding fathers throughout generation after generation. So when these out-of-state companies attempt to drive down wages, it's not just an attack on the working men and women of this state. It's an attack on the long-held values that our state has always held dear. Yeah. Yeah. Their effort to stir up division, to prey upon partisan instincts, only weakens Missouri's economy at a time when we need to stand together and to stand strong. And the ways that we will strengthen Missouri's economy going forward are right there in front of us for all to see. We are going to stand up for your spouses and your daughters as we pass a law in this state that says equal pay for equal work. Yeah! We will stand up for all workers in this state when we raise Missouri's minimum wage. The pre-apprenticeship programs that your organizations are championing across Missouri will provide job opportunities to those living in underserved communities across Missouri. Infrastructure funding for Missouri's highways and our energy grid will create construction jobs by the thousands while we rebuild our most vital assets. And expanding health care will bring billions of dollars of investment to our state's hospitals and create construction jobs across Missouri. These are the issues that unite us. These are the issues that move our state forward together. Every public servant who works in that building has made a commitment to maintain a strong and fair economy where every Missourian has an opportunity to succeed. But sometimes in the back and forth of politics, they lose sight of that commitment and they forget. But as I stand here today, I want to reaffirm my pledge to you that I will never forget the honor of standing up for you, your families, and the values that you stand for. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you, General Koster. You all know that this job is not easily done, and it's not done by one or two individuals. At this time, I would like to introduce and acknowledge Mike Lewis, President of the Missouri AFL-CIO. Missouri Building and Construction Trades Council Secretary Treasurer in my organization, Scott Grandin. Treasurer Jeff Abusi with the St. Louis Building Trades and Business Manager. And somebody that keeps me on track and is near and dear to my heart, business manager Elise Martini from the western side of the state with Kansas City Building Trades. Thank you, brothers and sisters, for coming out today. Remember, we are the people that build our schools and our churches. We are the people that teach our children and nurse our sick. We plow our streets in the winter, and we work in the heat of the summer, building and maintaining our roads and bridges. We are the working families in Missouri. We must stand together, and don't let them forget it. Thanks for coming. Travel safe.